we're allowing our good friend and brother Ramana Maharshi, who for sure saw through the illusion of time, space, process, and form, and was completely free of this delusion. We're allowing him to help us out a little bit. Now, Jesus, in this book, Journey Beyond Words, is a huge advocate of imagining as if. He says, allow yourself to imagine that this is the way it will be. Imagine as best you can the scenario. And as you begin to imagine, feel if you can, with total certainty and calmness, exactly what to experience. Feel, imagine, have faith, believe that this is right now you're experiencing what you really want to experience. This is very, very important. This is the little so-called trick that trips up the ego. It's a and you definitely want to trip up the ego. So we're trying this format right now as a way to trip up the ego through the capacity we have now with this little silly technology we have. We're able to imagine that we're actually with Ramana Maharshi here, and we sort of transplanted him to the North Shore of Hawaii, and he is, as he always is, in the timelessness, where the mind is thinking the thoughts we think with God, which are completely timeless thoughts. The thoughts that we think normally are all based on time. Now, I can vouch for this because yesterday I had maybe the best spiritual day of my life. I was able to make tremendous breakthrough and get past these clouds of thinking for a while. And then the clouds came back. And so today's like one of the worst days of my life. But I realized, yes, we can do this. Absolutely, we can do this. And for sure, that I know that someone like Ramana Maharshi, he did it. He absolutely did it. There's no question in my mind that he did it. And stayed free of thinking. Whereas our challenge is to, how do we stay free of it? And we can do that too. But we certainly need some help. And so I'm enlisting the help here. And we can get a sense that we're there. We're there with this great teacher. More than a teacher, example, this great example, this showing us a timeless mind is not only possible, it is our true nature. It is our true nature. And we can be here in the world even with a timeless mind. We absolutely can do this. But it's a bit of a struggle, as I've been experiencing. But high I was on, and when I was meditating and when I saw the egoic time-based thinking arise, I would keep practicing and push it away, and would try to come back and I push it away, and it came back in so many different guises. And then finally, during sleep, I had this dream where it showed just how tricky it can be. You know, it brings in dogs and puppies and surely you can't, you know, reject the time-based nature of this, of dogs, you know, of animals, of pets, or you know, children or women or something, you know, so sacred. You can't do that. And so the ego, which defends time, the ego's whole purpose is to defend time, to tell us that time is real. And by time, I don't mean chronological time, of course. I'm talking about mental time, that moments are bound together, okay, that moments are not free. One moment is not free of another, that moments are somehow bound together by, and that's what we call time. But this is absolutely not true. We're actually totally free. We are totally free each and every moment. So really the world doesn't exist, the time-based world that we talk about, again, not chronological time. Chronological time is just a convention we use so that we can meet up and do various things, and it seems to have better organization to it. There's all sorts of different calendars in the world, right? So what is today? Is today January 28th? Only in the Gregorian calendar. There's many other calendars who would say it's completely different. And we just kind of gradually came up to this, you know, 60 second to a minute, 60 minutes to an hour, and this kind of stuff. It's all just convention. We're not talking about that. We're talking about this belief that there's some existent cause, that somehow we need time, determinism, to be what we are, to complete what we are. Without it, somehow we're incomplete. This is a lie. This is a deception. And this is a deception that the ego supports entirely. The whole purpose of the ego is to defend time. It's its whole purpose. So when we see that time doesn't exist, and we assert this, the ego, of course, it fights back with like it's dying. And so it's quite troublesome. So the ego can never accept that time doesn't exist, that it's not self-existent. It's merely an idle wish, is all it is. It's not self-existent. There is no such thing or dynamic as self-existent time, space, process, form. None whatsoever. All of it is a mental wish that we are producing moment by moment. All of it. And it's possible to see this. And Ramana Maharshi absolutely saw this, saw through the whole situation, and just was very quiet. Okay, why is he so quiet? Ramana, why are you so quiet? We could ask him. Because truth is so perfect and all-encompassing that to try and explain it with words is damning it with faint praise. Very much so. So in just being quiet, it's easier to feel the perfection of it. The timelessness of it. When we start putting it into sentences and words, sentences, concepts, discussions, it takes on a feeling of time. It takes on a feeling of time. So Ramana said it is better, the most potent transmission is silence. Silence doesn't mean not saying anything. It means saying everything. Total expression. Complete expression. See, this is not an absence here. This is a powerful, powerful presence of completeness, a complete presence here. This is a complete presence. This is an example of what complete presence is. As long as there's still this suit, a human monkey suit, this is a great example here. So we can hang out with this great example like this. Hang out with this great example, and we will just take a look at this example. So again, is this muteness? No, it's the opposite. It's a complete expression. It's the complete expression, leaving nothing out, nothing out. It's the timeless expression. You see, what we are doesn't need any time to be what it is at all. And it's not limited by time. In other words, it doesn't need any time to be complete. It doesn't need any time to be perfect. It's perfect right now. And by being quiet, we get this moment by moment by moment by moment by moment experiencing of it's perfect right now. It's perfect right now. It's perfect right now. I don't need to do anything. I don't need to know anything. Nothing has to happen. It's already this way. It is already this way. I am already enlightened. I am already enlightened. This is true. All of us are already enlightened. Just the sun is shining, and maybe it's cloudy somewhere, and we don't see the sun, and we think, oh, where's the sun? Well, it's already there. It's already there. If the clouds evaporated and vanished, you would see, oh, there's the sun. It's been there all the time. So I'm already enlightened is a very powerful statement. I am already enlightened. I am already timeless. I am already timeless. This is what Ramana Maharshi is saying. I'm already timeless. There's nothing mental I need to do to be timeless. There's no timed expression that needs to take place to be timeless. There's no concept that needs to be considered to be timeless. So, timelessness is right now. And this is the potency that we're seeing here. Timelessness is right now. Timelessness is right now, completely right now, 100% right now. So I am 100% already enlightened right now. I am 100% already enlightened right now. I am 100% enlightened right now. And as always, we take breaks to feel the wow of the progress that we're making. Otherwise, at some point, we will panic. That can happen. I'm already enlightened. I'm already enlightened right now. Full stop in the wow. I already know that I'm enlightened. I already know that I'm enlightened. I already know that I'm timeless. And I already know that this timelessness is being reflected, is already being reflected in my body. I already know this timelessness is being reflected in my body. It doesn't take any time for this to happen. I already know it doesn't take any time. You see, the ego desperately defends time and insists that the body is somehow causative in some way. That form is somehow causative in some way. It's not true. The body is like a mirror. It's not actually causative. It's all in the mind. It's the mind that's causative. And what the ego does is it tries to get at least for us to admit to at least one value, time-based value in the world, at least one. That's all it takes for us then to believe in time and to be vulnerable to ego's defense of time. So we must be willing to not accept any valuing at all of time, space, process, and form. Saying it doesn't exist, I've already transcended this silliness. I've already transcended the silliness of time. I have already transcended the silliness of time. We can say, I am already Ramana. I am already Ramana. What is Ramana except timelessness being reflected in a body here in this world? That's it. Timelessness being reflected in a body here in this world. That's it. The body is not causative in any way. It's just it's a mirror. So, timelessness being reflected in the body. I am already timelessness. Reflected in a body. I am already timelessness reflected in a body. I know that I'm already timelessness reflected in a body. I already know that I am timelessness reflected in a body. There's no there's no complexity to it. Ramana Maharshi is simply what we call Ramana Maharshi, what we call Ramana Maharshi, is just timelessness reflected in a body. And we say, well, he's sitting there very still. Well, that's what he always did. sat very still like this. I mean, we're saying, well, this is an image, a picture, but it could be a living image, as it were. It could, because he sat quite still like this for hours on end. There wasn't anything he needed to add to it, you see. It's already timelessness. It's already timelessness reflected in the body. It's already timelessness reflected in the body. Again, this is not limitation, it's unlimited. How do you express unlimitedness? It's the best way is the silence like this. And the unlimitedness of spirit in relation to the body, reflected in the body doesn't really have to prove anything. Because obviously we cannot imagine the body could be unlimited and do anything like a spirit being unlimited. So as it just sits there silently, it's sort of representing, expressing unlimitedness. By not doing anything, the potential for doing everything seems to be symbolized. And it puts the body in the right perspective. That I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit as God created me. So timeless mind is possible, even when we seem to be in a so-called world here. Because all of this world and all bodies are just idle wishes that time be, that there be something called, we call time. It's an idle wish for time. It's an idle hope for time. That's all that it is. It's an idle wish for time. Even here we in the satsang get interrupted. One moment, please. What do? Call back. Call back. I will call back. Maybe turn it off. They'll probably call again. Well, having no pause button on this, it's live, we just have to keep going, right? That's just an interruption of time right there. It shows you how easy it is to get interrupted. But if we look at Ramana Maharshi, no interruption. No disturbance. Nothing disturbs. Nothing disturbs a timeless mind. No form, a mirage of time, fools the timeless mind. The timeless mind is not fooled. And yet we struggle mightily to just catch a glimpse of the sun beyond these clouds here. Just a glimpse of the sun we're looking for. And you see these clouds? We say, oh, there's the sun. I see it. But how do we get rid of these clouds? You see, in the timeless mind, there are no clouds. It's all clear. Everything is clear. It takes no time. Only the belief in time sees these clouds. The mind that realizes there is no time doesn't see any clouds at all. Doesn't see any obscuration of the light. Does not see any obscuration of the light whatsoever. I know I am already enlightened. I know that these efforts have already succeeded. I know that this success of timelessness is already reflected in my body. See, this is what is seen. The clouds represent a lack, not yetness, okay. But when we practice saying it's already happened, then we don't need any clouds of not-yetness. The clouds represent a struggle to get there. If we're not there yet, obviously, then we have to somehow view it as if we're not there yet. So if the sun is not clear to us yet, obviously we have to view a scenario where the sun is obscured, still obscured. But we say, I'm already, my sky is already clear. My sky is already totally clear. My sky is already totally clear. All clouds tracelessly, baselessly vanished without any residue whatsoever. My sky is already totally clear. And this total clarity in my sky is already reflected in my body. Okay, I won't make this one too long because this is a slightly a new format. So, and I can attach a video to the end of this if you want to continue on in just quiet contemplation. My sky is already clear. My sky is already totally clear. I'm already enlightened right now. My timeless mind is already perfectly reflected in this body. And I know that this has already happened. I know this has already happened. Now, we use the term happen just so that we don't become too abstract. After all, we're practicing. If we were completely abstract, we wouldn't even need to practice. So it's not a level confusion or contradiction to say something happened when of course, time has never happened. You know, but we say, well, it's already happened. It's already happened. This is a way of practicing. Don't be confused or concerned about it at all. We know what we're talking about. So I'm absolutely certain that timeless mind has already happened for me. And just accept this. Wow, it's already happened. I know that it's already happened. I'm already enlightened. I am already enlightened. Okay. Very great. That's it.